coming to you live from Bangalore, India, where we're giving you the latest SAP developer news right from SAP TechEd. And one of the biggest news items to come out of the day one keynote was the introduction of SAP Build Code. This is the latest pro code offering from SAP for all of our developers. First of all, what isn't it? It is not a product rename. So the products that you know, like SAP Business Application Studio is our development tool, and the Cloud Application Programming Model are still there. They're just now part of a larger bundle called SAP Build Code. The idea of SAP Build Code is to make it easier to provision all the services and tools that you need to build professional applications, but also make them work more seamlessly together with one another and the rest of the SAP Build low-code, no-code tooling as well. The other huge part of SAP Build Code is obviously the generative AI capabilities. You've seen it in this morning's keynote, and in the developer keynote at the end of day one, we're going to show even more examples of how we're using AI to power the next generation of our development tools to automate repetitive tasks, to help you learn better how to code in this environment, and also to help you with things like unit tests and test data generation as well. So all these amazing new enhancements are going to come to you as part of the new SAP Build Code. So be on the lookout for many more videos here on the SAP Developers channel over the coming months as we help introduce this new developer capabilities to our audience.
Embeddings are mathematical representations of the content, like words that we humans use, in the form of vectors that computers can process. I hope you haven't missed the announcement from SAP TechEd, where we are extending the multimodal processing capability of SAP HANA database in SAP HANA Cloud by introducing support for embeddings. AI models are stateless. The vector store in SAP HANA Cloud will make it possible to provide long-term memory for AI-powered applications. Embeddings can also be used to store sentences, whole documents, or other kind of structured and unstructured data to power the intelligent data applications you build.
So, we've got some great news for all of you developing on the SAP Business Technology Platform. You've probably already heard of the SAP Discovery Center. It's a great starting point to learn about all the resources in the SAP Business portfolio, and it's got tons of missions to learn from. Now, some of those missions now have direct deployment options, so you can use those solutions directly in your own landscape. Not only that, but we've also got a brand new SAP Developer Guide with detail on how to build applications and services on SAP BTP. The best part, this guide in the SAP Help Portal is part of the open documentation industry. So not only can you read and learn from this, you can contribute to it too. Check out the links in the description.
SAP will launch new generative AI capabilities for developers who want to build ABAP-based AI extensions. A planned system prompt library will help developers build apps for ABAP Cloud that includes corresponding unit tests and test data. Developers will be able to use these prompt-generated AI capabilities, explain and review troubleshooting existing ABAP code, and essential refactoring and optimizing existing classic ABAP code for ABAP Cloud. These advancements in AI technology will be available in 2024, making it easier for ABAP developers to maintain and enhance existing code. Click the link in the description below to learn more.